I'm super excited. So, now we get super excited because we get to do the mystery game. So here's how it works. Are you guys ready? Whoever you guys decide to be the team captain, maybe Lauren, she's like on the tall chair, pick a random card.
And you gotta play whatever game is in that card. Just know last month it was lip sync battle.
What's in it? What's your lip sync battle again? We didn't do this on purpose, guys.
Schoolyard insults. Yes. Yes. We gotta talk about each other.
Okay, so the way that this works, you guys are gonna face each other.
No.
We'll do them one at a time. And maybe Kim can jump in on this one. Do you want
to
do
it? Yeah,
so you will battle one of the others. No. So maybe you and Tamika can start this off.
Oh, no.
So you have to pretend like you're five.
Okay.
In the schoolyard during recess. And you have to insult each other.
Okay.
But so anyway, schoolyard insult. So I'll start, okay? So you get the idea. I was gonna be your friend, but I decided I didn't want to because you are a poopy squat head.
Gotcha. Okay, so is that reference to my hair?
Not like it.
Okay. Well, that's okay. I don't want to be your friend anyway because your shirt reminds me of the grass, and the grass is dirty.
Ooh.
I know, good, right?
Well, I was gonna be your friend, except I found out that you were a dirt licker.
Well, I wasn't gonna say anything, but I saw you pick your nose at lunch.
Well, it was delicious.
That's why I'm gonna tell Jason about your crush and that you pick your nose.
Well, I'm gonna tell Jason that your milkshake don't bring all the boys to the yard.
Well,
make it good.
That's okay because I don't have holes in my pants.
Burn!
You start. I know you're secretly mean.
Do you like teen books? Think of what your characters might say.
No, they say like really mean stuff, not like 5-year-old mean stuff.
Okay.
Rachel, I was gonna be your friend, but you were just not nasty enough for me. I'm trying to think of stuff my 7-year-old has actually said. Lauren, I was gonna be your friend, but your mom put a note in your lunchbox, and I think that's pathetic. That really happened.
Oh,
put it on the mom stuff so early. Rachel.
Escalator real quickly right there.
I was gonna be your friend, but then I heard that you were planning to lip sync to Taylor Swift, and she was just not cool anymore.
Lauren, I was gonna be your friend, but I found out 2 seconds ago that you don't like Taylor Swift.
It's true.
Wait, it's really true?
It's true. Rachel, I heard you were a science nerd.
That's true, too. I can't remember, but I think I'm out of them.
You can hit me in the language nerd.
You're really pushing.
That hurts because I've been a language nerd for a long time.
That's true.
Yeah, I love grammar.
I think overall, though, Lauren was the queen.
I don't know.
All right, thank you, ladies.
Good job.
It's so hard to be mean.
Not for me, it's not.
That's true, it's not.
I need a real chair next month. This is not working out.
It's like dealing with a child every day.
Every day.
You guys should see the shenanigans we get into in our office.
And, tell them how we got the office, though. We got the office because we were so disruptive to the library. They gave us a space.
They were trying to be nice and not kick us out. So they were like, here's this, like,
you guys can work in this space.
Go work in the closet. We have pretty sure the closet, though. That's great Wi-Fi.
It does have really good Wi-Fi. So now we're going to bring up one of our favorite people.
You guys can take a little break. Grab a water.
Yeah.
And then we're going to talk to our very favorite librarian,
Eric Carpenter. So Eric Carpenter is the school librarian, yes, at Toomer Elementary School. He is epic and awesome, and if you ever like Google Eric, you'll see he's done like 50 jillion things, too many for me to list.
Awesome.
So this is a segment we call Librarian Loves What? So this month, the book that Eric is telling us about is called Shade the Changing Girl, Volume 1.
Show it off, show it off.
This is the first issue. Do you guys know what this thing is? Have you guys seen one of these before? It's just connected with two staples.
Just two staples? That's it. Just two staples.
So this is what we had before, those wonderful thick graphic novels that you guys see in your library, right? I brought this book out because comic creators are finally making great things for teens. It took a long time, but they're doing it. It's because people like Brandon Telgmeier and Jenny Holm sold millions of copies of their books. And I bet you guys remember reading those in middle school. Elementary school, you were reading those comic books. They want you to buy their comics now as high schoolers. So you guys have to do it, okay? It's up to you guys. Because they're making great books, and then no one buys it.
So what's it about?
This book, thank you. This book, Shade the Changing Girl. It's an alien who steals his magical coat, transports herself to Earth through the madness stream. Very psychedelic, very crazy.
Wait, and madness?
The madness.
Okay.
Madness.
Go on.
Go on, exactly. So okay. I should flip through in a second. She inhabits the body of this real terrible high school bitch who her friends have put into a coma. She's brain dead. She comes in.
I didn't say it, but you're right.
This much hated high school girl who's been in this coma, her friends are kind of happy she is. This alien goes into her body, takes it over, she comes back alive. She has total control over this girl. So we have a nice high school story featuring someone that's an alien. I'm sure many high schoolers feel kind of like an alien sometimes in high school. This is an actual alien trying to go through the paces of high school. It's crazy. It's got female creators, female author, female illustrator, female anchor, female editor.
That is
crazy art. Just like out of this world. The alien comes to Earth because she's obsessed with a 1950s sitcom that's finally made it to her planet. So she wants to see that Earth. She gets here in 2016, 2017, doesn't see that. There are 12 issues already published. If people keep buying them, they're going to keep making more of these books. If people don't, it's going to go the way of a lot of our great new comics and disappear off the shelves because they're not bought. So go to the comic stores. I know they're scary places, but go in there. Ask the librarian to order these graphic novels. We don't need just Batman and Spider-Man on the shelf. We need things like Shade. We need things like Miss Marvel. We need Black Panther.
Ryan and I each have little segments that we do.
I'm ready.
You ready?
No, wait. It's yours first.
Okay. So every month...
Oh, can't wait for this one.
We're going to do Kim's Top 10. And this month, it's a different theme every month. And this month's top 10 is top 10 lines from Kim's inevitable lifetime biopic. Number 10, Officer, when this started, my dress was on. Number 9, oh, so I'm the only person with a public shopping cart in my house? Number 8, let's just spray paint these rocks and see if they believe it's real gold. Number 7, I had no idea I was wearing one shoe. Number six, excuse me, pumpkins are most certainly currency. Number five, on the count of three, just start screaming. Number four, Sheriff, this boob squeeze booth was approved by the county fair board. Number three, no, Your Honor, I was not aware that public urination laws apply to fountains. Number two, Officer, I didn't even know Jason Reynolds lives at this house. I'm not surprised. And number one of the top 10 line from Kim's inevitable lifetime biopic, have you met me?
I'm not funny.
And definitely.
So I'm going to share with you guys my little segment that's called Vanya's Dramatic Reading. And I have two books to share with you guys. I usually read a little section of it. And this one is called The Astonishing Color of After by Emily X.R. Pan. Beautiful cover. And this is coming out in March. Hold this. There's a lot of pages. This has a really great first line, and I'm so excited. Okay. My mother is a bird. This isn't like some William Faulkner stream of consciousness metaphorical crap. My mother is literally a bird. Aren't you intrigued?
Oh, I've been waiting for
this one. And this one that I'm so excited about.
Yeah.
By Tommy and Dayami, Children of Blood and Bone. By the way, this book has been getting so much hype.
Yeah.
It's thick, but worth the read. And I'm gonna read like kind of like the prologue.
I saw how that book has a poster on Hollywood Boulevard.
Yeah.
Like, that's amazing.
Yeah, I want our marketing
team. It's a beautiful cover too. I try not to think of her, but when I do, I think of rice. When mama was around, the hut always smelled of Joe of rice. I think about the way her dark skin glowed like the summer sun, the way her smile made Baba come alive, the way her white hair fuzzed and coiled, an untamed crown that breathed and thrived. I hear the myths she would tell me at night, sayings, laughter when they played Agwan in the park, Baba's cries as the soldiers wrapped a chain around her neck, her screams as they dragged her into the dark, the incantations that spewed from her mouth like lava, the magic of death that led her astray. I think about the way her corpse hung in that tree. I think about the king who took her away. A little bit different. Anyways.
I love that.
So, now to the good stuff. We're gonna play Truth or Dare. Are you guys ready for this? This is always my favorite part, to be honest, because it is the most we get to embarrass those lovely guests of ours. Me and nails don't work. All right. Truth or Dare, Lauren.
Ooh.
We're making room here, guys. I'm gonna get this.
I'll start with truth.
Ah, all right. That's me. What's the worst thing you've done to meet a deadline?
Oh man, it was painful. So I had to rewrite, like, it was either, I don't even know anymore, probably like the last half to last third of my book within about 2 weeks. And I like did not sleep for most of that time. And I know that I was basically working on it at my day job. Yeah.
Oh no, don't tell.
No one's here for my day job. So, but yeah,
this is going on YouTube.
I know.
We'll cut it out.
I just added myself here. Yeah. No, I would sleep for about 2 hours, and then I would go to my day job, and I would sneak in more editing and more rewriting there, and then I would go home, and I would eat dinner, and I would put on some pajamas at about 6 o'clock, and I would edit until again about 4 o'clock in the morning, sleep 2 more hours, go into work, and let this cycle continue. So I don't know if this is embarrassing, it's just like tiring and sad. But that's the truth.
So
if
you guys
want to
be writers, this is your future.
The truth is no sleep.
All right. Rachel, truth or dare?
Dare.
Okay. Pick a partner. I'm not telling you what for yet.
Is that legal? Give me some down.
Shush. Get up here. All right.
Well, I don't want to say.
This is not as bad as you think. All right.
That scares me worse.
Because you know us so well. Okay. Rachel, don't hide over there on the chair. Step up next to your partner. Give me the mic. You don't need it for this. You guys are gonna do a walk-off.
Like a supermodel walk-off.
Right. Now make it good.
Okay.
Because we have a prize for the winner.
The winner gets a prize.
The winner gets a prize.
Okay. At the end, you have to do your best blue steel face.
Like that.
Okay.
So you can use this right here.
Just run right, but we have to walk downstairs.
Yes, you can go downstairs. It's a runway.
Chihuahua, or lipstick.
These are horrible options. Where am I going to end?
Slay a dragon.
Slaying a dragon. This is a
important
task.
What I would do with those items?
You only get to pick one, and you have to say why.
I will take my lipstick. And the reason why I would take my lipstick, because to slay a dragon, perhaps if I distract him with my lips somehow, I can, I don't know.
Punch him in the nose.
Yeah, punch him in the nose. Yeah, I can win the fight and distract him with my mouth.
I really wanted to have a baby as an option, and then Jesse and Bonnie wouldn't let me put it on
there. Take the baby to slay the dragon?
Yeah, because the dragon opens his mouth and just hurl the baby inside. So then you already prepped the baby to poop, right? And then the dragon is like, what just happened? And then the baby poops, and then you snatch the baby out, but the poop is still in the dragon's throat. Dragon's
tail. And
you can
make
up with the logic. It totally makes sense, right?
Yeah. This is cool. You just have to see it. The video.
Chihuahua.
Nice guy. Chihuahua
wearing
diapers.
All right, Laura. Truth or dare?
Yeah, I'll take dare.
All right, we need a blindfold. How many fingers am I holding up?
Zero.
It was two. All right. We need a volunteer.
A week.
You can't say that. So you have to now. Don't say a word and stand in front of her.
It's an inappropriate motion.
Yes. We will help you with this.
Okay.
You can touch her face. Yes, it is. A little lower.
Someone from the audience.
We'll give it to you. After you choose your friend, you have more chance of guessing it. All right. Good job. I know. You weren't inappropriate.
You know that.
Success.
True.
Okay, fine.
What was your worst kiss and why was it so bad?
Don't say your husband.
He's gonna watch this.
Those are the best.
There was this boy in college, and afterwards, my friends and I gave him the nickname Cow Tongue. So that should give you an idea. It was really, really good looking, but he just had a really giant tongue, and that's just really gross.
Was it like licking? You're like,
there was like spit everywhere.
Run away.
No.
Oh,
yeah.
It's not worth it.
Not worth it.
All right, Tamika.
Okay, I'll be here. Yes.
Oh, gosh. Can we have this book? All right. We're going to read. Actually, I'm going to have Kimberly read the scene. Because I've been doing enough reading. She's going to read the scene, and as she reads it, I want you to do an interpretive dance. Now, by the way, if you guys have read this book,
okay,
you might know the scene. Go for it.
Okay.
Interpretive dance to my favorite scene from Simon versus the Homosapien Agenda. He likes to imagine me fantasizing about sex. That's something I probably shouldn't have done. I lie here in the pitch darkness reading that particular line on my phone again and again. I'm jittery and awake and completely in knots, all from an email. And I'm hard. So that's kind of strange. It's really confusing. A good kind of confusing. Blue is normally so careful about what he writes. He likes to imagine me fantasizing about sex. I thought I was the only one who had those kinds of thoughts about us. I wonder what it would be like to meet him in person after all this time. Would we even have to speak? Would we go straight into making out? I think I can picture it. He's in my bedroom and we're totally alone. He sits beside me on the bed and turns to look at me with his blue-green eyes, Cal Price's eyes, and then his hands cut my face, and all of a sudden, he's kissing me.
Last round.
It's the final
round. So then you can give you guys some awesome gifts.
Yes.
Lauren.
Yeah.
Last. Truth or dare?
Truth.
Mm-hmm. This is from the audience. This is the audience submission.
If you could replace any character in your book with Draco Malfoy, who would it be and why?
I have a younger sister character in my book, and she winds up sort of like being possessed by musical magic, and I think it would be really weird to have Draco Malfoy in that role, like sort of wildly playing the piano and getting swept up by magical spells.
Nice.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That would be interesting. All right, Rachel. Truth or dare?
Yeah, after that last dare, I'm gonna pick truth.
Okay.
All right. That was for the record books.
I'm
going to do another one from the audience. They said, who is your actor crush and why?
Jason Momoa from, like, well, specifically when he's Khal Drogo in Game of Thrones.
But also Aquaman. Ooh. It's okay, yeah. If
you haven't seen it. Just look in the pictures.
You just see this roll.
Or like the clips. There's like a B-roll of him just coming out of the water. You see how she got lost? She was like, and then there's a B-roll. And then if you go to this,
I have visions.
Visions. Tamika, truth or dare?
I will finish on a high note and do the dare.
Woo! Yes! Woo!
Okay, I'm gonna sing.
Alright, let's see. Hold on. Okay.
Try
and lick your elbow.
That's your audience. That is not us.
Yeah, that's not us.
Who wrote this?
She told it, like, was like, yep, that's me.
Oh, it's not gonna work, ain't it?
Try the other one. That right there is a fair cheat. If you guys gotta give a round of applause.